Beloved Parthurva, respected minister, he is handling so many departments. I do not remember them. I don't know how he manages so many departments. But I must say that it's a pleasure to be here. I thank the organizers for giving me an opportunity to address my friends, my colleagues in the channel, as well as companies and members from the government. You know, within such a short time, I think this new government has been there for only 60 days. I have seen Parthurva at least in 6 or 7 IT functions, you know, and he's handling so many departments. So I'm very, very hopeful that, you know, this new government, especially the IT industry, is going to benefit a lot. I recall the meeting which our Honorable Chief Minister had called for the industry. You know, the first thing she said was IT, amongst all the industries that she's planning to promote. Then it was tourism and then a few other things. So it was very delighted. We were all very delighted in the industry that our Chief Minister is definitely looking to focus on IT as one of the key drivers for West Bengal's growth. Having said that, I would like to, you know, take this opportunity to highlight a few points about the MSME industry in India. There are almost 2.6 crore units which are all in the MSME segment. They are employing more than 6 crore people. And we are more or less, you know, contributing to 40% of the country's gross domestic product and 45% of the country's exports. Now, if you see, this is a phenomenal number and the government is very concerned and the government wants to help all SME companies so that they can grow. Now, this is where I have some suggestions to the government also. The government of India has got a lot of schemes, which many states are taking, but West Bengal, you know, over the last 30 years, I am one of the oldest IT entrepreneurs in this city. I started almost 24 years back when we used to have only Lal Jhanda if you talk about computers. So from that time, I have seen the West Bengal government had changed over a period of time, but they never could utilize the opportunities provided by the central government funds and central government grants for development of specifically the MSME industries and the IT industries in particular. So I think under the National Manufacturing Competitiveness Program, there are, I think, more than 700 crores available, which can be used by MSME companies for modernization. All the IT companies, they are all looking for more customers, more business. Now, our customers are SME companies or government or large companies. And SME companies will invest in IT only if they get some support. And MSME contributing so much to exports, it is very important for them to modernize and IT enable their operations in case they have to survive in the competitive market. So the government of India has recognized this very well, and they are providing a lot of support to so many MSME companies. But the state needs to act very proactively in drawing these funds and also enabling the flow of funds to the SME. If you see, in India, the bank credit which is given to MSME companies is close to about 400,000 crores, which means 4 lakh crores is the bank credit to almost 2.6 crore, 26 lakhs unit, which means more or less you can see that the average credit which is given to a single MSME by our bankers is only about 1.5 lakhs. This amount has to be much, much higher. So the availability of bank credit to smaller companies is very low compared to international standards. The availability of credit to large companies is very high. So the government has also set up very ambitious plans to drive more credit to the MSME sector. And they have set this as a priority sector, especially for the smaller companies. We also have certain schemes in the government. I'm not a government servant. I'm purely a private sector person, but I'm only trying to address the opportunities that we have if we do the work properly in the state of large amount of funds which are available in so many different ways so that our customers can get funded for modernizing their activities and we also can get more credit and more support to participate in e-governance projects and many of the other projects. Today, the government of India is one of the largest buyer of IT services. That's why all the companies which were doing exports earlier, because of the global recession, they're also looking at India. India's spend on IT is going to be close to $70 billion in the next 4 years. And out of this, the state also, every state is also allocating a lot of budgets. You see the UID project itself is, I think, 6,500 crores. It's one of the mammoth programs which has been ever launched in any part of the world. About 121 crores of people are going to have their unique identity. And these programs are all rolled across the state and funds are all available. So my request to our Honorable Minister is, sir, there is a phenomenal opportunity for West Bengal. There is a phenomenal opportunity for especially SME companies, because we are the people who normally deliver the last mile for any large project, whether it be Infosys or Wipro or TCS or anybody. You know, the smaller companies are the ones who actually do the execution of the last mile work. And it is very important to support smaller companies in West Bengal. We have got a lot of innovative companies, but unfortunately they do not get the type of support from the government, whereas other governments like Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Gujarat, even Bihar, they have come up with very good schemes for financing startup and innovative companies. Innovation is something by which West Bengal can really progress. We have got tremendous amount of innovative talent in West Bengal, especially the young people with whom I work quite a lot. I mentor a lot of startup companies. I see phenomenal opportunities, especially for the smaller companies to become global players. In fact, there are two companies from Calcutta, you know, which have literally become global because they got acquired by a global giant who scouted all over India and found these companies in Calcutta. So there are phenomenal opportunities that we have, but we can reach those targets only if we all work together. So I would request our Honorable Minister to come out with a very dynamic IT policy, which should be the best policy in the country, so that the next 5 years, you know, we can have a very good policy which will promote all types of industries in the state. I also would request that, you know, the venture capital fund, which has been started for innovation, especially in the IT sector, be revisited. Then we need a venture capital fund for other SMEs also, which means it's just not IT. There are so many non-IT areas, because Parthodaya is the industry minister. There are so many non-IT areas where there is a tremendous opportunity for smaller and younger companies, and they require support. And this support can come from the government. I think the government is drawing up a plan to raise a lot of finances, and the type of money that is required for supporting these small companies is very, very minuscule compared to the large amount of money which the government will have to raise in order to take its program forward. I am representing Compass today as the president. I am very glad to tell you that we are one of the most dynamic and vibrant organizations of IT channels in the country. Recently, we have taken an initiative to consolidate all the IT association in Eastern India, and we have formed a new confederation called Confederation of IT Industry Associations. We got more than almost 4,000 partners who are all part of our ecosystem. They drive 80% of the business in the channels. So they literally control the market. We believe in very ethical values of doing trade. We fight against anything which is not right. And we also, and irrespective of our member or principal or distributor, we always take the right path. We are absolutely against software piracy. We are continuously launching programs to educate people. We are also doing a lot of non-profit work, like we have set up a lot of training centers for computer, you know, literacy, especially for the weaker sections of society. And till date, you know, with the help of, you know, non-profit organizations, we have trained more than 2,000 people in getting basic IT skills, and many of them today have found jobs. So I think it is not very good to expect too much from any new government, but it is always good to share and participate in the progress, in the vision that the new government has set up. And from Compass, you know, I would like to assure 100% support to our government in taking their initiatives forward. We are willing to take any responsibility, we are willing to share any data, and all we want is West Bengal and SME companies in West Bengal should progress very fast and create more employment and more exports from the state. I would like to close my statements here. Thank you very much.